Ghost Entertainment, I darkest society neighbors. No jokes! A stubborn real man, mule. Scorchy talk your mind.
Chaka P, never know me have so much bad mind, friend. Kill me start scorchy consignment. Chew me, I help myself. Help. Them want see me life and scotch.
Get the youth. Them know we firmer than them.
And them.
Them know so we full of confidence. Build me circle, me never beg no strength. Freestyle and it's very evident. Watch them. I dead, them want we dead.
John dead.
Run gun, put a millip on me head.
Want spend.
But Jaja nah sleep, nah sleep.
Careful how you spread your bed.
Mr. People, people. Them are too evil.
Corrupt.
Quick fit change like season.
With
the same one where your feet took. We kill you, me tell you about people.
Me I tell you.
Them hard to heave. What if a great man miss it, them kill.
The motherfucking biggest.
You remember?
I swear. We the motherfucking biggest. Pain don't care about son. Put your lights out. Know how many homies I see die when it's nice out. The motherfucking biggest. I swear. We the motherfucking biggest. The motherfucking biggest. I swear. We the motherfucking biggest. Pain don't care about son. Put your lights out. Know how many homies I see die when it's nice out. I'm the big daddy king with the raw fool. Now what you want, huh? You're the dog fool. Keep it a kilo, know it's hard as me. Burped out the water, started charging fees. Surfing made backs kinda hard to breathe. So we posted on the gram for the cops to see. I'm too deep, deafer than designing. Been freshman since the class of 9-3. Motherfucking bigot. We the motherfucking biggest. Pain don't care about son. Put your lights out. Know how many homies I see die when it's nice out. I'm the big daddy king with the raw fool. Now what you want, huh? You're the dog fool. Keep it a kilo, know it's hard as me. Burped out the water, started charging fees. Surfing makes backs kinda hard to breathe. So we posted on the gram for the cops to see. Motherfucking biggest. I swear. We the motherfucking biggest. Pain don't care about son. Put your lights out. Know how many homies I see die when it's nice out. I'm the big daddy king with the raw fool. Now what you want, huh? You're the dog fool. Keep it a kilo, know it's hard as me. Burped out the water, started charging fees. Surfing makes backs kinda hard to breathe. We posted on the gram for the cops to see. I'm too cheap, deafer than design. Been freshman since the class of 9-3. Jesus with Mavic, pull up a chair. Talking LeBron James, I'm Ohio player. It's common sense that I'm VI. Racist if you're
this house, yo.
I caught my daughter staring at the beanie piece on the wall within seconds. Teardrops started to fall, I'm sentimental. I'm from where they make it so hard to escape the devil. It's dark and hell is hot.
From the Ted Smooth headquarters. It's the biggest in the motherfucking game. What's good, y'all? What's good? This the global currency. Know what I'm saying? Been rocking it. New York, everywhere I go, everybody giving me a little something. Culture. So I pull up. You know, I try to represent the culture. Wild Cherry Pepsi Fridays. Ciroc. A much finer. Shout out to my brother, the one and only Diddy. He just hit me up. Everybody keeps asking me where Khaled's at. I cannot tell you. He's chilling. He's great. I let him tell it. So, you know, all the Khaled fans, come off the DM. You're going hard. Yo, Joe, where's Khaled? What's going on? This? My brother's great. Alhamdulillah. And so, Wi-Fi, because it says keep saying poor. All right, so global citizen. Now, check this out. Rashid Belhassen in Dubai. he wins the victory. Rashid Belhassid in Dubai. Salam alaikum. He wins the victory. And so it's summertime in New York City. I had to come up here, get to some things. You do know, up NYC, home of the wave. Got the Flyers gear, the Flyers sneakers. Yesterday we dropped those Travis. Only two stores in America with that Travis. That's Kith, and that's up NYC. And so we representing brown and black excellence. And thank God our kids could get the Flyers shit. And so, you know, what I say earlier, I say, I said, I don't pray for lighter burdens. I pray for wider shoulders. I don't pray for lighter burdens. I pray for wider shoulders. Meaning I take the whole hood with me, man. New store coming in September in the BX. Looks like you in the fucking Hamptons across the street from the projects. That's what we do. And so our kids, they spend money. They love being fresh. They love being fly. For too many years, they've been neglected. We got to go downtown and get the fly shit. No longer. BX, uptown. We have the fly shit. Up NYC. DT Barber, I see you, baby. Hot freestyle, what's good? And so, you know, Rashid Belhassid, my brother, I love you. Shout out to Pristine Glaciers of Ice. Now, ain't nothing fucking with this. Nothing fucking with this. And so, since I put it on, it's kind of hard to take it off. It's kind of hard to take it off. Straight water, straight Aquafina, Fiji, in fact. Bum B, what's up, my brother? Buy local. You right, Bum B? You know what we doing for our kids? And so we make sure we take care of the hood. You know, the new store, I ain't telling you, I ain't them.
Rich, let me do it, please.
Hold on, y'all. I'm coming back, please. Fucking man, we in the Dungeons and Dragons. And so check this out. The new store, we have a learning center for the kids that want to do good in school and don't have computers and they need to do their homework after school. You have a safe haven. You have a place to go to. All inspiration. That's all we do is provide inspiration. Sung Lee. Now let me tell you. Let me tell you something. Back in the days when Khaled used to DJ on the radio, he would never take a day off. They would tell him all the time, you want to take a vacation? You want to take a day off? He'd be like, no way. Because even if he had pneumonia, he made sure that no DJ came up behind him on his day off and killed them on the ones and twos. So he didn't even give these guys an opportunity. When you give somebody an opportunity, you shit on the money. And so I'm going to just leave it at that. Be mindful. When you don't show up to work, when you want to take the time off, someone is always there to take your slot. That's all I'm saying. I'm not going to say what's in reference to, but I'm being honest. Now, Sung Lee at the Olympics, beautiful Asian sister, proud American, took the gold. And that means she'll be getting the money. Okay? Be clear. Don't shit the money. That's your money. And now, yesterday, Russell Westbrook to the Lakers.
Yes.
I see you, Mayor. DT Barber. Russell Westbrook to the Lakers. This is a problem. Russell Westbrook to the Lakers. Now, AD, LeBron, if healthy, with Russell Westbrook, third strong option. Shout out to Kuzma. They gave him his chance. He's the youth. He got a long future, but they gave him his chance. And so now Westbrook coming over there. I want to see what they're going to do with the other pieces and all that. My Knicks, we ain't do nothing miraculous yet. I'm tuned in. And so my birthday's coming up. You know how we do. We go hard or we go home. So for the B-Day, we're going to throw that extravaganza. Silk shirts. Fly shit. No jeans. Silk shirts. Listen, let me tell you something. When I do my birthday parties, I do it for my people. For my friends. For my family. For being loyal to me. For being sincere. I throw it back to them. Whether it's on a yacht with Mary J. Blige or this and this, or whether it's Keith Sweat with it in the fly as shit, the 40-40. I do it for my people to have a great time and to thank them for being loyal to me and how much I appreciate their friendship, their brotherhood, their sisterhood. So every year I do it big. Mixtape coming, August 6th. Not for motherfucking play. It's not for play. It's not for play. I don't play with these guys. So the shit with me is, this is a marathon. And when it comes to this rap shit, it is a marathon. Meaning, when I came in the game, I used to look up to certain rappers like they was gods, like they was invincible. Then I kept practicing and practicing. The anthem here, number one there. Anthem here, number one there. Anthem, a love song, a this, that, to the point of where I let you be the judge of it. I want you to take whatever albums or whatever mixtapes or whatever comes out and really listen to it and see who's the nicest in the game. Simple as that. I don't play. When I say a mixtape and it's free, it's nothing but hits on there. And if you want street shit, it's fire. Nobody fucking with me, man. Listen. Shout out to all my friends that have COVID-19 right now. Shout out to all my friends and family that have COVID-19 right now in real time. As we speak, and it happens to be 7 of them right now. I love you guys. I know you see me. You know I'm talking. God bless you. I'm praying for you. I hope good health. I hope you get past this. And a lot of my friends and family, I've been begging to get a vaccine. They don't want to listen to me. Nobody want to listen to me. They know some shit I don't know. And now motherfuckers got the COVID all over. But you know what happens when you get the COVID? You say, damn, why ain't take the vaccine? All I had to do was take the fucking vaccine. And so we send in prayers. The Delta's a motherfucker. The Delta strain is a motherfucker. And what I notice is, Bin Laden could be in a cave in Afghanistan, but he could affect what happens here, as you saw on September 11th. So now a new Delta, some new shit comes out of India, killing India. All you watching on the news is everybody falling out in India. God bless them. 2 weeks later, somebody from India comes over here, Delta all over the place. Now the motherfucker jumping all over. It's more contagious than ever. They're telling people with the vaccine, wear a mask. Because even if you got the vaccine, it's not true. You got to understand, I'll talk about Biden. I talk about Biden bringing our troops back from Afghanistan. I'll talk about Biden getting the vaccine to everybody. You don't want to take it. It's crazy. They did a poll. And I love everybody. Human race is human race. But they did a poll of all the people in the hospital, 37% is Republicans, Trumpers, that believe that the COVID is a hoax. It ain't real. And when you turn on Fox and all that, they talking about, yo, you don't need no mask. Fuck that. This, that. Okay. And then they passing the hot potato. That motherfucker jumping off. I swear to God, since COVID started, now I got to admit, God bless. I think the doctors have learned to deal with it to where you don't really die unless you like. Look, I got a guy with the vaccine. This is the craziest shit. I got a friend who took the vaccine and got COVID and almost died, 99% dead. He had 1% alive and he turned it back around and he lived. He almost died with the vaccine. So what does that tell me? If he didn't get the vaccine, he'd be dead. He'd be dead. And once again, I never got paid by a vaccine. I'm just trying to tell you whatever y'all want to do. Yeah, you can stay woke. You broke. Yo, so a voter died. You know, they try to hit me with a letter, but you broke, bro. You ain't telling me something I don't know. I took the vaccine 6 months ago. I got no twitches. I got no nothing. I'm good. I'm eating just as good. We having a fun time. At least I know I'm not going to die. You guys, enjoy the battle. It's some asshole shit. It's like jumping off the fucking airplane. Or rock climbing the biggest mountain. You guys want to see how far you can go. Fuck lucky. The vaccine's for free everywhere, guys. There's people in other countries that are dying to get this shit. Rasha Belhassid, I see you, my brother. Salam alaikum. I'm proud of you, man. You went to work. You had that fight. It is what it is. I'm telling y'all the truth. Y'all can believe whatever the fuck y'all want. I'm telling you the truth. I don't sound like white folk. I sound like somebody who's living. That ain't white folk. What black folk sound like? What the Spanish folks sound like? You got me fucked up, man. I'm trying to help you. I'm telling you the truth. What I can tell you is this. I tell you this all the time. I'm in the hood. I speak to homeless people every day. At night, I might be on a yacht. You know I'm not lying. You see me with the billionaires. What I can tell you smart guys is the second they invented a vaccine, my billionaire friends ran through concrete walls. Like, what was my man? The Hawaiian Punch guy?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. The motherfuckers ran through concrete walls to get the vaccine. On God. On everything. But you know something. You sitting on a milk crate with some fucking, sage telling me you know some shit. You told me you knew the YG Towers did it at the beginning. 5G. You guys don't know shit. You got a cousin that works at the fucking Pentagon. Get the fuck out of here, man. Yeah. Hey, you gotta listen. You guys are crazy, man. Listen, man. Do me a favor. I love you, man. Get the vaccine, man. Do me a favor. Get the vaccine. At least you got to fight. I'm telling you, man, you people are crazy. It don't matter. If you get the vaccine, you can be infected. But the chances are you won't be hospitalized or you won't die. I'm telling you real shit. Y'all don't want to listen? It's cool. You want to think it's a hoax? You want to think it's a joke? You think you're crazy, bro? Y'all crazy. I mean, the fucking Delta is not playing. Do me a favor. Go look up Peru. Go look up Colombia. They got some shit called a Lambada. No! There's no room in the cemeteries. They got to burn bodies. God bless. They have the Lumbada. Do not know who the fuck y'all talking about. I'm on today. Y'all listen to me, man. I'm trying to help you, brothers. I'm trying to help you. I don't give a fuck about Bill Gates. What, Malika or Melquan? Fuck out of here, man. With the scientific shit. Fuck out of here. I know what I'm talking about. Get the vaccine. It's crazy out here. Yo, look up Bill Gates. Look up how the train system was made in New York, God. The aluminum, no. Vaccine yourself, please. Live. Please. Fucking, like, yo, these guys are movies out here, man. Yeah. Check this out. Shout out to Joe Biden, who pushing the envelope to make the Dreamers United States citizens once and for all. Obama talked about it. Never did it. Trump played around, but he wasn't serious. Joe Biden has made the next step to making our Dreamer brothers. Not Dreamer brothers. Yeah, it's mostly Latinos, Mexicans, South America. But there's also Africans. It's from all over. These are kids that their family brought them to this country to live in a better place, who don't get in trouble, who go to school, and were raised here their whole life. Imagine if you were brought as a baby to America from Belize, and all you know is America. And then somebody comes snatch you out your bed 18 years later and tell you, yo, go to Belize. And so Joe was fighting for them. Joe was fighting for them, and he made the step, the 99% step to getting them actually citizenship in America. And the way I feel is when you go into the Statue of Liberty, nobody was really from America, guys. And it kills me when I got a Puerto Rican or a black guy talking about, yo, they ain't really from here. We're not from here. Everybody was brought here. Italians, Irish, whoever the fuck you name, Jewish, Statue of Liberty. And so you got kids that grew up here for 18 years, their whole life going to school. Give them a chance. Give them an opportunity. So the point is, when you realize immigrant from Jamaica. When you realize that together you have numbers and there's power in numbers. You can't be divided. If there's a black issue, if there's a Latino issue. And you might as well just count poor white people into the equation because that's what it is. Everyone together in inclusion. Very, 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 very important. And so, well, the natives, the Indians, you know, were here first. Yes. And so, listen, I can argue with anybody that wants to think. I'll argue with anybody with what I'm saying. What I'm saying is what I truly believe. I never say stuff that's manipulated. I never say, you know, I say stuff that I really believe. Now, am I right all the time? It's up to you. I know that I have the vaccine. My son Joey has the vaccine. My daughter Azzy has the vaccine. My wife has the vaccine. My mother has the vaccine. I'm not telling you to do some shit that I'm not giving to my own family. It's my brother. I'm just trying to wake you up because you catch the COVID. Then you start saying, damn, man, I should have had that vaccine. But Fat Joe been telling you forever to get the vaccine. No, it's the truth, though. Fat Joe been telling you before they made the vaccine. I was like, I'm getting the fucking vaccine. Did I not tell them before they even made it?
Big facts.
It's simple. And so everything, you know, and that's where we at with it, man. You know? And so me, I keep my word, man. Everything with me is about my word. My word is law, is bond. I prove it to you all the time, but you want to keep worshiping these mumbo jumbo guys that could give two fucks about you, man. Not for 1 second. And don't worry about how I pay my bills. I don't worry about how you pay your bills. If it's righteous and ain't stealing from nothing, nobody don't worry about how I pay my bills, man. These guys, you know, so they choose false narratives. And they lie to you. And you know, man, it's some haters that go above and beyond to discredit the real. It's pretty amazing. It ain't just like a Republican Fox News. It's dudes in the hood. You know, these guys are amazing the way they lie. Dudes in the hood be lying, man. And so anybody who sits there and goes out their way to create a lie and to promote a lie even more and back it up more, it's sad, man. It's sad, man. And so we for the people. We gonna stay for the people. And I spoke, you know, I call myself an 88er. Meaning I was outside for real. 88? I was an 80. I'm an 88er. You know what I'm saying, Ted? Ted's moving. I was outside for real. And I don't take it away from nobody who was outside for real. And when I see people, I address them at their biggest moment. Right? That's how I deal with people, Ted. I deal with them at the, like, yo, this is such and such, yo. So, you know, and it's unfortunate sometimes when you got guys, you know, it's sad, man. Because I was telling my brother Pistol Pete the other day, I said, yo, Pistol, you know, we're unique, we're rare. You know, we see guys from 88 or guys who went to jail for 20 years and we salute them like when they was the biggest guys in the world and we show them and we humble ourselves. But, you know, it's not 88. And nowadays, they ain't got it like that. They ain't walking around with a $1 million watch and shit. So I could understand some of those guys' bitterness to where they're like, damn, bro, Joe was in the streets with us. He's still shitting on yachts and all that. And so they... So the human instinct is, unless they real family with us, they got to have some guys that's bitter. Like, damn, man, look at him. He's always talking shit. He think he the realest dude. He's this and that. You know, listen, man, I never prayed for one of these guys to get, locked up. And when I don't stink out here. And so it's amazing when I see these guys and sometimes they come, you know, with the hate in their blood. I'm like, damn, bro, I'm just a reflection of you. Thomas T. What?
Black Thomas T-H-O-M-A-S now. Black people unite and let's all get down.
I got it. Yeah. The wave don't stop, guys. The wave don't stop. It's summertime. And I invited a guest. Hopefully, we get the brother on here who truly means summertime to me. Let's see if he accepts What's up, y'all? Don't worry about her. She's Vanessa bugging out right now. She acting like she don't know we on here.
Want me
to
hit her?
2 hours.
Vanessa?
Yeah, hit her back.
I got it.
Let's play some music right now till DJ Tess moves on the one and twos. Let's play some music. Matter of fact, back it up, do it big. We play some music till we get my guests on here. You know what I'm saying? Who represents summertime. It might have been that motherfucking wire that paused us. Motherfucking biggest. I swear. We the motherfucking biggest. Pain don't care about nothing. Put your lights out. Know how many homies I see die when it's lights out. I'm the big kid staying with the ball, fool. Now what you wanna have? Show the dog, fool. Keep it in here, know it's hard as me. Burst out the water, solid charging me. Surfing makes that kinda hard to breathe. So we posted on the ground for the god to see. I'm too deep, got the damn design. Been freshman with the class of 9-3. Easy to remember, pull up the chair. Talking LeBron James, I'm Ohio player. It's common sense that I'm VIP. My wife pull up to the bank, she don't need no ID. Wait to take a rest on a Sunday. Last a dozen 300 footer, fix a Monday. The sun goes down, that's the magic hour.
Yes.
The magic hour.
Wait, and when you hear that GRE, that's the madness hour. Look, niggas mad as ours. Yo, I caught my daughter staring at the BBC from the wall with their testing. Teardrops started to fall up to the level. I'm from where they make it so hard to escape the devil. It's dark and hell is hot. I make dope, drug dealers, cops. Spin the block, click, stay here to stop. I hurt feelings before I kill them. Push buttons, drop bodies. Teflon, dog, John Gotti. I got it coming in the colors. Good fellas, all you see around me. We stick to the script, no Scorsese. It's something like Rich Porter AC. Based on the real life story.
The sun goes down, that's the magic hour. The magic hour.
And when you hear that GRE, that's the madness hour. Look, niggas mad as ours.
When the sun goes motherfucking biggest. I swear, we the motherfucking biggest. Pain don't care about nothing. Put your lights out. Know how many homies I see die when it's lights out. I'm the big kid's gang with the raw fool. Now what you want, huh?
Dear God, I want the kid to take me. Feel the body in my mind, soul, and my body. Dear God, I want the kid to save me.
She goes society, trying to keep an eye on me.
Dear God, I want the kid to save me.
People, we got it in my mind, soul, and my body.
Dear God, I want the kid to save me.
Task move, straight face, you remember?
Yeah, it's wicked on these mean streets. Proud of my friends speak, we all trying to win. But then again, maybe it's for the best though. Cause when they're seeing too much, you know they trying to get you touched. Whoever said illegal was the easy way out, couldn't understand the mechanics. And workers of the underworld, granted, 9-to-5 is how you survive. I ain't trying to survive, I'm trying to live it, I'm living my little life.
That makes us crazy. Yo, Carl, what's up, my brother?
My brother, how you feeling, man?
Let's bring it back over here for a little bit, and then we get back into that DJ shit. Yo, Carl Thomas.
I saw you on it, man.
I call you Mr. Summer. Because your shit, Summer Rain.
Real talk.
It's like your music was built for summer.
Man, that's great, man. That's gravy, man. How you been, brother?
Man, I'm good. Not as good as you, man. You looking younger than me, man. You looking sharp. God damn, you look like a young boy out here, man.
Man, I'm out here in Las Vegas right now, man. Rehearsing for a residency I'm about to start.
Wow, is it just you?
Yeah. Well, no, it's actually myself and Dave Hollister. And Donnell Jones, my Chi-Town brother.
Oh, man, I got to come to that shit, man. You know, Dave Hollister was my neighbor when I first moved out the Bronx to Jersey.
A word?
Yeah, I swear to God, he showed me how to live, man. He was like the OG. Nah, real talk. He was like the OG. Shout out to Bernard Alexander, too. So Dave Hollister was my next door neighbor. The first fly crib I ever had, he was my neighbor. And I used to go see him and shit like that. Dave, a good guy, man.
Hey, that's fly, so man.
And Darnell Jones, very, very, very underrated. Very. He's incredible.
Man, you know, we just recently made an announcement, you know, that we are we're coming together as a group, you know what I mean, as an R&B group. And it's something that we always wanted to do, something that we should have did 10 years ago. But the group is called The Shy. You know what I mean? The group is called The Shy.
The group is called The Shy.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So Darnell Jones, Dave Hollister, and you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I mean, let me tell you something, man. That's going to be some shit. And y'all start working on music yet?
Absolutely. We've been recording records and just actively looking for material. We're up to putting a challenge to the system put in place. And you know, if you pay attention, it's like if you pay attention to the echelon of the Grammys, you know, you'll see as the night progresses and the awards go higher, R&B falls off at a certain point. You know what I mean? So, I don't know, you know, that may be for a number of things or whatnot, but we're out to record the biggest records possible. You know what I mean? Right now, so that we
know
can...
when I go, Carl, when I go and I look at, like, because you know, rap music, for a certain reason, when you look at rappers, you can have a guy one day be on top of the world making $200,000 a concert, and 5-10 years later, when he ain't the hottest, they trying to give you 12 grand. And so, not real talk, like, we're gonna talk real. And then when it goes to R&B artists, say Frankie Beverly and Maze and all of them, from what I know, I hear they get the bag. When they 100 years later, they still making a lot of money.
Right. Absolutely.
So I look at it in a different perspective. I've always looked at it like R&B stands the test of time. When it comes
to absolutely. A lot of it does. Yeah. But you know what's crazy, Joe, is that we're moving into a different era right now to where a lot of individuals, you know, our age and our age bracket, we grew up with hip hop, it's all that we know, it's all that we've ever been fed. And we're moving to this stage where we're in a different era of life, but at the same time, there's nobody is going to tell us that we got to give it up. You know what I mean? Like, that's just absolutely not going to happen. So I'm really interested in looking at the landscape of, like, what's going to happen and what is happening to, you know, artists, you know, that came out in a different era of music that is still continuing, you know what I mean? Still continuing.
I just think, you know, as long as you make great music and you're true to the people who've been following you for all years, yep. That's all you can ask for. You work it.
That's,
you know, you guys,
you
once again,
for,
you got, you know, a big lane with the Urban AC. Y'all got a big lane.
People,
that's all yours.
A lot of people question, you know, the state of R&B and whatever. Honestly, I don't even know why people even ask my opinion about that shit. But honestly, I really don't really share the opinion of a lot of people that, you know, R&B isn't what it used to be and what have you. Honestly, Joe, it's not supposed to be what it was. We're supposed to be reaching. We're supposed to be aspiring. We're supposed to be moving forward. So the sound may go through a few eras, you know, that people really don't appreciate. I remember, I'll never forget, you know, hip hop going through the same growing pains. You know what I mean? I'll never forget that, you know, and everybody, you know what I'm saying, was just like,
man, they had some whack shit out.
I remember when New York,
remember something I wanted to turn
to New York. But I
one
remember
time the hip hop went through some shit, I wanted to die.
Yeah.
Literally.
Yeah, but
you know,
hip hop's
my life, my soul. It was so horrible. I was like,
right.
I want to die at
things,
this
but things eventually got back on track. You know what I mean? Just like, I think there's a lot of R&B artists right now that are really not getting that just due that they really deserve. I really don't think
that some of the young really boys and girls that
Jasmine Sullivan like they're supposed to be. They're not really appreciating, just the different acts that are coming out that are really, really landing on the line for the legacy. You know what I'm saying? Anderson .Paak is not really getting the respect that he deserves. You know what I mean? I mean, and these are people that are putting it down. You know what I mean? I just think that R&B, we got to be better corporate partners in order for people to see us in the light that, you know, see us in that light, that that mainstream light that they want to see us in. Hip-hop is a very, very good corporate partner, man.
You know, in hip-hop, Carl, they had this thing. Well, they still have it. But, so you come from the street. You're very talented, right? But you don't know, you ain't into accounting. You don't know none of this shit but making music. So this guy comes, he throws you some money. You start thinking he's the savior. You pour all your heart into the music. You sell millions of records. The minute they feel like they don't need you no more, they'll leave you homeless. And I watched them tell guys 26 years old that they're old school. And the next thing I know is, guys would be 26 years old doing the old school at noon tour. It's fucking crazy.
Yo, man, but let me tell you some crazy occurrences that I just kind of, me just snooping around and I found out that those type of things really don't exist in white music. I learned that white executives don't even use the word relevance. It's only the urban artists that they use this type of language with, relevance and what have you. And I pretty much, you know, I liken that to just the tribalism that we've always tried to escape. You know,
but what I'm saying, Carl, is at now with this technology, look, we have our own media platform, right? So now with this technology, you could go independent, put out your own music, work your own music. Your fans can listen to your shit on Spotify, on Apple, whatever the case. So
right.
I don't think the day of put me on or what could you do for me even exists no more. It's all about us creating a team, market and promote. I'm putting out a mixtape August 6th, free for the people. I'm putting this shit out.
That's right.
And so it's like, I don't need to ask somebody, yo, what they think of their approval, whatever the case may be. We take matters into our own hands. Right. And that's how you should approach it. Like, fuck what they think.
Absolutely.
And it was amazing because, listen, let me tell you something. If Carl Thomas, Donnell Jones, and Dave Hollister really get in the studio and really work on a project, it's going to be amazing.
Yeah.
And the people are going to fucking love it.
And we're just trying to do something good for R&B, man. And that's really, like, people want to look deeper within the meaning of the meaning of the meaning, and it really ain't even about all that. We just came together because we really just wanted to do something exciting for the game, and that's it. You know what I mean?
Man, that's amazing, man. You know, I'm having my birthday, and I try to get you. And I wanted to I wanted you to set the whole shit off. Summer rain.
Yo, when is it doing?
My way. You know, I needed that shit, boy. You know what I'm saying? I know you booked that day. Is there no way we can outbook them?
Oh, okay.
You booked the day of my birthday.
Thank God the bookings are starting to come back, though.
Shit, I want to outbook these guys.
Yeah.
You know?
That's what I'm talking about, man. Hey, you got to make sure, though, you know, we'll be at the Aria Hotel and Casinos. And you got to make sure that when you take your Vegas break, you know,
well,
that
I'm
you
coming.
Come by and see your brothers. We'll make sure you and your lovely family has the front row action to the, you know what I mean, to the show. It would be an absolute honor, Joe.
Man, that's going to be an amazing residency. I see Usher out there killing them too.
Yeah.
And the thing, yeah, the thing that's so beautiful about...
And Rick Ross is about to start at Drea's.
Who?
Rick Ross is about to start his residency at Drea's.
Yeah, yeah. I was out at Drea's, but it's a different residence. What you talking about having like a real Vegas show that Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday.
Same musicians, though. That's the miracle of it all. The miracle of it all, you know what I mean? New Edition is about to start start rehearsing for their Las Vegas residency. So black music has a very strong presence right now in Las Vegas. And honestly, on this level, I've got to thank Boyz II Men for kicking those doors down for everybody.
Speak on it, because they've been out there for a while.
I really do.
Boyz II Men been killing Las Vegas for years.
I have to thank them for Vegas seeing the value in R&B music. Yeah.
I mean, you know what it is, man? You know, Vegas is based around gambling, and it's based around people who become a certain age. They like to have a good time and don't like all the craziness and the ruckus. But you can see your favorite artist there. You know, and smartest guys in the world, man, because now I got you guys, then Usher. I got two back-to-back to go to. You know, my daughter went out there. One of her best friends, Jaden Pitts, her godfather is Usher. So they was out there for the first day of the residency. So my daughter went out there to Vegas. She loved it. She had a great time. You know, she swears Usher knows her. He told her a joke or some shit. And she thinks like she's that one of them. Honorable mentions, Carl, you know, Biz Markie passed away. God bless.
Yeah, man. They're having the legendary Biz Markie. And they're having the ceremonies on Monday. And, you know, due to, you know, my schedule, I won't be able to make it. But, man, I wanted to be there. I wanted to be there for Biz. So, you know, I sent the biggest thing I could send. You know what I mean? For my brother. He encouraged me. Biz encouraged me doing some real dark moments by sharing some of his dark moments with me. You know, and this is at the time, you know, he was living in Bowie, Maryland. You know what I mean? Down in Bowie. You know, and he really became a guy of that community, and he let me see that. You know what I mean? That, you know, yo, this is my community, what have you, you know. And it's a beautiful thing. And, you know, he just left such a beautiful legacy. Biz, in a nutshell, man, Biz taught people how to be nice to each other, man. Just to keep it simple, man.
And I believe that everybody has a tailor-made relationship with Biz Markie.
How does that man make everybody feel special, man?
I do not know how this man has a personal relationship with every human being in America. I don't care if I'm in Miami, I'm in LA. Wherever I go, there, yo, Biz pulled up on me one day at 2 in the morning. He told me, I'm like, damn, Biz was everywhere, man.
Everywhere, yep.
Man, that's crazy.
He would talk to anybody.
Would we see a cameo on Puff's new album, The Love?
I don't know as of yet, but I've been listening and definitely keeping a close ear on everything that's going on. That's the project that's coming out incredible. You know what I'm saying? And I consider that move another good look for the game. I don't know what inspired him to make it R&B, but I'm glad he did.
Are you glad he did for the whole genre?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
I heard it's going to be incredible.
Yeah, I just love shit that makes sense. You know what I mean?
That's a fact. Who are the guys that inspired you?
That's one thing about Heavy D. And one thing about Heavy D, and I'm sure that you know that as well.
One of my idols.
Don't really know how deep into soul music that Heavy was. You know what I mean? And for those that don't know, Heavy D actually produced Summer Rain.
Wow! Heavy D produced Summer Rain?
Absolutely. It was produced by Heavy D, Warren Campbell, and it was written by DJ Rogers Jr.
Let me tell you something. The only time Heavy D ever got upset with me, he's one of my idols. I rap with Heavy. He came in the studio and he played me a song. He said, yo, I made this for you. And at the time, I wasn't ready for a song like that. I was still Gangsta Fat Joe, Underground Street. This before I ever had a hit.
Right.
And I said, yo, Hev, you know, I'm not feeling that. I don't want to. Yo, Heavy D got so upset with me. Right? We always remain brothers and everything. Rest in peace. But, man, that's the only time ever he got upset with me. I guess he felt like, yo, I came to give Joe a hit, and he didn't accept my hit.
He didn't know how to take it.
And let me tell you something, man. Heavy D produced Summer Rain. That's crazy. I'll tell you about Summer Rain. I was at the Rucker coaching, and the DJ played that for the first time, and the whole, everybody got up in their white tees, Summer Rain. Yeah. And I was like, oh my God, this is that shit. Like, it was like fucking amazing, man.
I don't know what it was, but when that album was released, and this is just crazy, just irony of the universe, but when that album was released, I just happened to have, you know, multiple loved ones on lockdown at that time in the penitentiary. And Joe, funniest shit in the world, man. I must have started 18 fights in jail from cash. I was like, that's my cousin.
You know, when you see the TV show The Shot, does that show an accurate description of what growing up in Chicago is like?
I would say that it's an accurate description of what's happening in the hood everywhere. They like to villainize. One thing that I recognize about this game, man, is that they got to have a bad guy to point the finger at. And if you look at the murder rates and the crime rates and things like that, it's other cities that are experiencing those same type of hardships and being squozing like that, you know, on the streets and whatnot by violent crime and things like that. But it's just like, I remember when it was LA's time, you know, for them to be the poster child for everything wrong with America, you know what I mean? And it's just, I just kind of look at it right now like it's Chicago's time to be to blame, you know, for everything that's wrong in America. It was crazy because right before Los Angeles, it was New York, you know what I mean? I came to New York. I moved to New York when David Dinkins was being voted out. I mean, not when David Dinkins was being voted out, when Mayor Ed Koch, excuse me, was being voted out. And David Dinkins was just becoming mayor. You know what I mean? So I was like, I literally experienced the New York City where cats was literally rolling down 42nd Street, popping guns up out of the car. You know what I mean? Like, it was literally that wild. So
now you was in there.
Everything wrong with America was New York's fault. It's New York City's fault. And everything going down at that time, you know, the Central Park Five just happened a few years previous to that and what have you. And it was just, you know, everybody got their time. The powers that be, the big guys, you know, in Washington, you know, they got to point their finger. It's just, you know, somebody else is going to be next. Somebody else.
Carl, let me ask you a question. Any legendary classic stories with B.I.G. that we might have never heard?
Nothing legendary. The most things I remember about Big is just coming in the studio, watching this cat break on everybody in there. You know what I'm saying? Like, he was the type of dude where you could absolutely know that cats have been coming for him because he was fat and black and what have you. Cats have been coming for him. You know what I mean? So he had an arsenal. You know what I'm saying? To ward off any of that. It was just he was just an extremely funny dude, man. An extremely funny dude. And I was really surprised that he even liked, you know, the hook that I did on his album. And I actually did the hook when he wasn't in the studio. Of course, I'm talking about The World Is Filled. on the Ready to Die project, of course.
The world is filled with pimps and hoes.
Man.
We just talked about those I know.
I did the hook when he wasn't in the studio, so I was really...
I'm making it hot.
That kind of didn't set well with me because I really wanted him to like it. And so I kind of had to walk in the studio, you know what I mean, and kind of get his approval after the fact. And he loved it, man. And that could have... That could have really shook my confidence had he said, that ain't for me, player, you know.
Let me tell you something, boy. You got to work with the B.I.G. while he was still in the world, man. And
a pleasure, man.
The fact that they call him like...
Absolute pleasure.
He's on everybody's top five ever. You know, to me, he's the greatest rapper ever.
I'm probably one of the only R&B artists that have songs with Big and Pop. You know what I'm saying? Probably.
What song you have with Pac? I know Dave Hollister got music.
Yeah,
with Pac.
I did a song with Pac a long time ago, and then it came out on one of the projects that they put out after his demise. And that project was, I think that project was called Pac's Life. You know what I mean? And it was a song called Dumpin'. That I did with him, and I think Hussein Fatal was also on the record. And, you know, I got a chance to just having the type of career and legacy that had the opportunity to touch these guys, you know what I mean? And the tenure that I had before I was an artist, making my way in New York as a starving artist on the open mic scene, you know, it was one of the most interesting, you know, schools that I ever been to before. I got a chance, you know, to be down in the village at Cafe Wild watching Dave Chappelle sharpen his shit, you know what I mean? And Dave was the type of cat that where, you know, he may have just shot a movie or something, man. He didn't even care about getting up in front of open mic and just, you know, making everybody laugh. And I thought, you know, and of course that's what he was doing, but of course he was sharpening his shit. You know what I mean? You know, at the time, you don't really see that because you see the genius now. You know, I got a chance to graduate with a lot of wonderful, wonderful people, a lot of wonderful artists, you know, that exploded into on the scene at the same time that I did. And it's really cool to be friends with a lot of those people still to this day. I don't really think God makes mistakes. I really think that I was at the appointed time and appointed place, you know, to
call, because I never get you, because I never catch you. Can I get a little bit of Summer Rain on here, man? The big show. Can I get you to just
storming outside rain? She keeps me home. And a quiet. Conversation makes me warm, so warm, sweet rain. Hey, there you go, baby.
Your caller is legendary shit, man. I mean, before I leave, your top five R&B singers of all time.
Damn, Joe. Damn.
Okay. I know. All right. I know.
Okay. I think I can.
Everything can't be fun and games. It got to be some.
I'm going to go from five to one.
Okay.
All right. Number five, I would have to say Nat King Cole.
Ooh.
Number five. Number four, I would absolutely have to say Brooke Benton. Mr. Brooke Benton. I don't know if you ever heard that song.
No, I'm learning some shit.
In Georgia. You know what I mean?
What was the record?
A Rainy Night in Georgia.
I got to look up Brooke Benton.
Yeah, you got to look that up, Brooke Benton.
I got to look him up.
Number three, I would have to say Daryl Coley.
I'm sorry about that call. I'm sorry. Somebody was calling. What's number three?
Between Daryl Coley and Charlie Wilson. Yeah, and Charlie Wilson. I would say the number two would have to be Al Green.
Ooh.
For me. And number one would have to be Mr. Stevelin Wonder, Stevie Wonder.
Wow.
Yeah.
Stevie's in a lot of people's number ones. You know, I mean, you got an interesting list here. I thought I know everything, but I gotta get on Dal Cole. I gotta get on Brooke Benton.
Absolutely. You know,
I gotta get on that.
Say it again.
I said I gotta get on to Dal Cole and Brooke Benton.
Daryl Coley, Coley, last name Coley, Daryl Coley.
I got him. Everybody else, I got him. My brother, absolutely. I love you. When can we see the show? When can we see the show in Vegas?
Say it again.
When can we see the show in Vegas, the residency?
We're starting up in August, man. We're starting the first weekend in August, man. So you got to come check us out, man.
You know, I'm going to check you out because I'm in
hotel and casinos.
I'm in L.A. August 11th for like 2 days. I might drive down there to Vegas to come check y'all. I'll get in touch.
Also, my brother D. Nice. My brother D. Nice. Everybody, he is doing right now the Club Quarantine Concert Series.
Wow.
Club Quarantine Concert Series. And we're going to kick it off, I believe, on the 29th at the Hollywood Bowl in L.A.
Wow.
At the Hollywood Bowl. But there's also going to be another one in Brooklyn, New York. And then there's also going to be another one in Atlanta, Georgia. You know what I mean? So the Quarantine Concert Series. Y'all can follow me at Carl Thomas Now for more information. But man, he's got a wonderful lineup, of R&B hip hop artists that I'm sure everybody gonna appreciate and get down with. You know, it's really in there, man. It's coming.
My brother, I love you. Thank you for getting on with me, man. Nothing but love.
Thank you, man.
And I'll see you. I'm coming to that concert.
Absolutely, man. Joey, thank you, man. You always,
my brother.
Always a straight up dude when I see you, man.
God bless you.
One of the guys, like, what's crazy is that you're one of the guys for me who is in that Dougie Fresh category. And what I mean by that Dougie Fresh category is Dougie's in that big category where every single time I've seen Dougie, I meet the same guy.
Me too. Tell him, actually, he smiles so much. My gimmick to my slogan to Dougie is like, yo, stop smiling, B. Stop. Dougie's just always smiling, man.
He's always smiling.
Great attitude.
But I love that, brother. The same way every time I've seen you, you've always been the same Joe, man. You know what I mean?
God bless you, man. Love. We still here, man.
Absolutely, man. Love you, brother.
My brother. God bless you, man.
Thank you, man. One love.
Ladies and gentlemen, Carl Thomas, the one and only. Tess Move, are you ready?
You don't know who I know.
You don't know who I know? Because you don't know who I know. You don't know who I know. Right now, we're about to turn up the Tess Move. I just talked to Carl Thomas. I don't know what you... I got a feeling Ted gonna take us to that summer vibes right now, something legendary. Wow,
Chess Moves, straight face, you remember?
You remember?
Come on.
Got your tongue, boss, man, got your strong. Or maybe I ain't. Oh, oh. Oh, let's get to that two-step. That two-step bounce, come on. That's more straight face. You remember?
Shout out Carl Thomas, top down in the building.
Top down, left lane. You ain't no foot in the pedal.
Outside, will she keep me home?
And I say right about now, y'all.
The quiet, the conversation.
Where you at? Where you at? Everybody,
move it out, cool out, here we go.
My computer, man. I think I'm batting 1,000, man. I'll be having these joints, y'all.
Money earning my burning. Yo, AP, what's good? Let's go. Let's go.
We on that summer vibe. We on that summer vibe. Hold on.
You took me to that tempo.
That new jack swing, come on.
How would you feel if I bumped you down? Make your head spin like I'm ever going down. Take control like Charles in charge. I really can't wait, let's stand on the rock.
You remember?
Can't have
Uncle Dan, what up?
You get me with your hands.
Oh, Lord.
You caress my skin. Your heart come back. Girl, hypnotizing with your eyes.
We live with Ricky Dan Parks. It's going down Friday. The Rock Ball Jelly, let's go.
I
love it. Hold on.
Feelings
can
be strong. The things you do to me. Oh, it brings out ecstasy. It really turns me on. Oh,
one time for the lady.
Baby, I'm addicted to everything.
Ladies, one time the bills. That's what I'm calling, Joe. Guess what I'm calling, Joe? Your brother. Your brother, Nori. Oh. Nori sound good on everything.
I'm here for more.
Oh, that vinyl. You hear the cracking on that vinyl? That Joe, where was you in 1983 when this thing rang off on the handball court? Where you was at?
I had no permission to be in the party. What?
We are party mode.
I've never seen you when this come on in the same room.
Hold on.
Now my computer's still going crazy. Shut the hell up. I never witnessed in the same room when this come on right here. That Tesla remix. Oh, Lord. This is Joe Promoting. What's up? One request. I need to hear Mama used to say,
oh, come
I need Junior. Take your time, young man. Being that you in that.
I'm in that vibe.
Being that you in that zone right there, I hear some Mama used to say, don't you rush to go.
My God, am I correct? Are these are congas or bongos?
Those are bongos, baby. Let them rip. Hold on. Let's take you back to Tiffany Street and put it out, Bronx. House parties in the basement. Lord have mercy. We in the vibe. Junior. That bell was so crazy.
bag is mean today, Fat Joe. Hold on, sir.
To Rock Wild Kevin on a Friday, why wouldn't you test move Fat Joe the Jumper Show? We now.
No cap, no lie. You know how people be like, people find somebody, be like, yeah, I knew that. No, you didn't. Listen here. Just not too long ago, I found out that Michael Jackson was doing the hook on this song. I never knew. I never knew. You got a story?
This was Berry Gordy's nephew who decided to make a song one time, and he asked Uncle Michael that was hanging out in the studio to sing the hook. And Uncle Michael couldn't say no because Barry Gordy put him on. And so he did this right
crazy.
Here.
Crazy. Mike, do you mind laying this reference? Me.
MJ on the hook.
MTV classic, Bob. You know what it was. 8:30 in the morning before he went to school. Hold on. Here at the Jumper Show, everything for everybody. You know we do. Catalog heavy.
I'm just an average man with an average life.
Crazy.
I think from 95, hey, how I pay the problem. I want to be left alone in my average home. But why do I always feel?
Hey, Mike, can you lay this up for me, please?
I always feel.
Yes.
Somebody's watching me.
Gangsta. The people gotta understand. Before hip hop supposed to get the chin. Well, tell me some rock parties, hold on.
It's almost time for the people to depart.
I know. Woo! I know we need to go. I know we need to go.
Marvin, it's the joint.
Y'all sing that joint right now, you know.
It's the world's biggest this live anthem. Listen to the lyrics. It's called Victim.
We talk about time.
this music.
Stop this music.
They got the
shoes.
They got the shoes. They got the
shoes.
They got the
shoes. Oh, by the way, tonight, Tess Moon and Con Sofrito in the Bronx with Jimmy, your boy. The after party, hold on.
Come on, baby. Let's put the music playing. I wanna see you dance. Get on my ass. Ooh, yeah. Ooh. Ooh, yeah. Come on, baby. Let me show you what I make you do. Let the music. Oh, yeah. Tune into my soul.
We got it all.
Yo, listen.
We got it all.
Listen, let me tell you something, man. Bring it closer, man.
Rich player leaning back like, damn. Yo, I remember.
Wow.
Red zone. And, you know what I mean?
My favorite.
We
Lord have mercy.
Yeah, yesterday we joked to Manhattan. He was like, yo, this is the red zone. This is the red zone. I was like, yo.
That's my favorite club ever.
Yo, listen.
Huh? I got his.
I do not know why I love the songs where women are shitting on the men. I don't know. I have no clue. Historically, since I was a kid, I've went back to the archives and studied that I don't know why I love the songs where the women are giving men hell. Ted Smooth. You are always the best and the biggest. Thank you for getting us through a pandemic that hasn't happened in 100 years.
Crazy.
Do you realize that? This show was started is for you, by you, for us, by us. And so we took on the tough task of cheering you up, getting you informed, letting you know what's what, thanks to all the talent who has been here over this last year. And of course, you the people, because if it ain't for you, it would not be no us. Check this out. Do me the biggest favor and let your darkest moments bring your most clarity. Let your darkest moments bring your most clarity. So you go through something, hard time, family problem, get locked up, little illness. The people you thought that was real, that were supposed to be by your side, they're not there for you. Don't play yourself. They're not really your people. The last one I leave you with is God is great. God is phenomenal. God is with you in good times and bad times. See, some people, you get locked up. You're fighting for your life. You get on your knees every day. You might go to jail for 20, 30 years. Oh, God, please, please, please. And then he blesses you and gives you another chance. And then you come out here and you forget all the times you was praying to God. That's not the deal. The deal is to maintain consistency with the powers that be. So love God in good times and in bad times. And he's always there with you. Now I'm going to tell you something. I tell you what I mean and tell you what I feel. If I'm about to die, and I have 5 seconds or 10 seconds, I'll be praying to God. Okay? I'll be praying to God. Stay faithful, stay real, believe in God. It's the only way. It's the only way. And me, I'm the last guy that you would think would be the messenger. But you know, some people who preach to the converted, meaning they preach to the guys who are already in church 5 days a week. That's cool. But the guys who speak to the guys who might need it, the young ladies that might need it, that's who I talk to. I don't ask to lighten the burden. I don't pray to lighten my burdens. I pray to make my shoulders wider. We get one chance here, man. We're here temporarily, y'all. Do what makes you happy. Hopefully it's not drugs, but do what makes you happy. Whatever. You seen the gun? He said, nah, leave the drugs alone, bro. We need that. We need that methamphetamine.
Right there.
Yeah, they need that dead end. God said, hold up, Joe. They need that dead end. Listen, y'all. Nothing but love. Love, y'all. We the biggest in the game. There is no one bigger. And you don't know who we know. Shout out to Carl Thomas, because you don't know who we know. Shout out to Ted Smooth Fridays. You know, we always do it great. You finally got your tickets, Fat Joe fan of UK. Fat Joe fan of UK, been my fan for so many years. If the first time I'm going to the UK in 10 years, he don't go or she don't go to the concert, they have a problem.
Something right.
You got to be kidding me, right? So I'm out there. I'm doing the big festival and doing the after party. I'll be out there with y'all. Lucky Church, what's up, baby? What's good, y'all? All right, y'all. Peace. We the biggest in the game. Biggest.
You remember. Ustad told us I don't seek. No, me can't avoid her. She can't avoid me. And every time when me ogar up, well, me have to say, girl, hey, you squeeze me tighty. Say you're regular, she boost me up. Tell her friend them say me know me stuff. But she beg she have to talk, cause she can't take a picture and post me up. Had a bad touch there. Make she a text said. Another same bad touch there. Make she no one left.